Very interesting. I've worked with Nokia pretty much my entire career. I started way back in 2000, worked on Nokia networks, worked on Symbian, did some development there, then worked through the chain in R&D, then in about 2011 moved to marketing, did that for about 5 years, and currently now in this avatar at HMD Global, I work on the portfolio and I'm building some of the products that we are creating. So we officially, as a company, we got incorporated on the 1st of December. I have been working on these since about August. 2nd of August is when I actually joined. Some of my colleagues have been doing this even earlier. So they've been in the works for a while. You can't make this kind of products overnight, right? So it takes a lot of time and a lot of effort and a lot of precision to make these products. So I'll start with this one.
Yeah.
It's something very special. It's obviously something that all of us would relate with. It's something that takes us back 17 years, yet is very, very modern and today. So it's obviously the most popular Nokia device ever. And when we speak to a lot of consumers, and when we were starting off, we asked consumers what their favorite device is, and it had to be the 3310, you know, given all the memes of indestructible and breaking the floor and all of that. So our design team, so we have a in-house team of experts. You must have seen the video as well. Really great guys sitting in UK, and then they started actually experimenting with this, and they said, why don't we bring back the 3310 but in a completely modern avatar? So if you see, even with the colors, what we've done is we have the same blue and the gray which the original had, but then two completely new colors which are very, very relevant also from today's day and age point of view. And while we don't really talk about it, because this one is about 1 day of talk time, 1 month of standby time, and snake, right? But this also has data, which is very relevant for today's times. But we've, you know, it's a very good mix of the old and the new, because we've brought back the old UI, yet we've put data on it. It has a camera on it, yet it, you know, we talk about the calls and the text. So, and we did this yellow, and we have a very beautiful warm red. And like I said, with the blue and the gray. So really something that I see a lot of young consumers, even a 17-year-old, using this. They were probably not born when we introduced the original one, but they would, I'm pretty sure they would love to own a phone like this. And also people like you and me who've been fans of the 3310, I mean, wouldn't it be great if you had just carried this to Barcelona on one charge and you'll get through the whole trip and you would be reachable, right? So it really appeals to everybody, and that was the whole intent, and we've got some really fantastic response on this device. Yeah, you could trust it with your life, yes. But I haven't tested that use case specifically. No, it goes through all of our devices, and I'll talk a little bit about the smartphones also. But we take quality very seriously, and all of our devices are really, really durable, reliable, and they speak quality. And quality, not in the boring sense that, you know, oh yeah, there's some quality control happening. Quality is in terms of when you just hold it, you know that this is something special in your hand, that everything has been thought through, be it the materials, be it the finishing, be it the components that you use, and that's what we really obsess about. So yes, it's gone through all the most stringent Nokia quality standards, and that's how this has even passed our test. So it's very durable. This is the Nokia 6. So clearly it's a lineup, and I can show you each of them, but let me talk through the pillars of what we've built our product strategy on. So we clearly want to do three things, and I know Ajay also spoke about it, but at the risk of just repeating what we've been saying, we want to focus on three things relentlessly from a product strategy point of view. Number one is core experiences of our consumers. We spent a lot of time researching. A lot of research has actually gone into the devices in markets like India, in a lot of Western markets, etc., to really understand what is it that consumers are have as core needs from the category and our pain points today, right? That's the first pillar. The second one is, we saw it on the 3310 as well, it's about quality and craftsmanship. And the third is our very, very unique take on Android. which is that we will give choice and control to consumers, and therefore we will have the purest version of Android. So that is something you will see across the range. But yeah, the first one is the Nokia 6, a beautiful 5.5-inch display on this, and it's a complete immersive entertainment experience. So we've thought about the entertainment experience across. So you have dual speakers on the front, you have Dolby Atmos playback, and obviously the screen helps a lot in that direction. We have a great camera story on this, so 16 megapixel at the back, 8 megapixel in the front. In fact, it's 8 megapixel across the range, all wide angle, all autofocus, all 84 degree wide angle. We also have a PDAF, so face detection autofocus, which means that it can really do the focus very quickly so that you can do fast captures. So great camera story as well. And what else? Yeah, so complete entertainment device. And yes, this is how every device is actually going to be out of the box, that you have the Play Store right up front. You have the whole Google folder with the Google apps, and that's it. And then consumers can basically choose to download what they like. And the Play Store is right there. So it's intentionally kept really clean, because we want it to be as close and closest to the way Google has envisioned Android. So that's the Nokia 6 for you. The most important part, I'm sorry I forgot, is the design. And what we've done with this one, and also this one, and here I'll talk about a little more as well, but what we've done is we've taken one block of 6000 series aluminium, and we've actually created this product from that. So it's actually crafted from that, and then we've anodized it a couple of times, and then we've polished it 5 times, and that's how you create this. There are no seams. It's absolutely seamless. It's a unibody design, and clearly this is something that can even break nuts, and that's been proven in our Chinese launch. What I loved the best about this Nokia 6 in China, and we'll obviously, we have a lot of expectations from it in global markets. We spoke about focus on the consumers, right? And we started with China. 74% of the consumers who bought the Nokia 6 in China are young millennials, which means that we are, you know, while we will welcome all our Nokia loyalists with open arms, we also want to be very, very, we want to appeal to the younger consumers as well, and it's actually playing out better than I had, for example, expected. So that's on the Nokia 6. You will see a similar unibody design crafted from that block of aluminium also on the Nokia 5, but we've done something even more special with the Nokia 5, so on the design. So if you see, this is a complete plain back, as we call it. So the most difficult thing to do on a unibody is the antenna technology. So you want to make sure that you have the metal, or you want to make sure that it looks really premium, but you also want to make sure that you have great call reception and uninterrupted call quality. What we managed to do was, if you see any unibody from anybody out there, you will see these lines of antennae. We actually took it all the way to the top and the bottom, so your back is absolutely plain. All you see is the Nokia logo, and that we've done with the Nokia 5. Other than that, exactly the same pillars that I spoke about. If this was a 5.5-inch, this is a 5.2-inch. I like to see this as the most optimum experience out of the entire range. So it's a very pocketable screen size. If you look, it has a very nice pillow design. It's the most human design out of the lot. So really nice fit in the hand. And we have some very beautiful colors from there. So if I can show you even this one, this is my personal favorite. We call it the tempered blue. We have it across the range, but it looks really beautiful with this plain back. Thanks, Susha. So that's the 5.2 versus the 5.5-inch. We have a good camera layering also. So you have 16 megapixel, 13 megapixel, and then 8 megapixel. And all of them have the, like I said earlier, 8 megapixel front camera. Both of these come with the fingerprint sensor. That's right. And yeah, and
the
then
processor as well on both.
The processor on both is the Snapdragon 4 series, so 430. And then coming to my favorite device, that's the Nokia 3. So this one is at this price point, and this one will be at a global average of about 139 euros. It's probably the most premium design that you will ever see. And the reason I say this is it has an aluminium frame. It has beautiful finishing. It has a polycarbonate back, and it has a stunning display. And this is a polarized display. So basically we put a polarizer to make sure that the irrespective of viewing conditions, your display experience is brilliant. So be it in bright sunlight.
Even under harsh sunlight.
Even under sunlight or even in
a country like India where
yes.
a lot of the use is outdoors.
In fact, that's exactly the insight that you don't want consumers to go like that or like that or then walk into the shade just to be able to answer a WhatsApp. You know, you can do it in bright sunlight and it's a beautiful display. And actually, it's true for all of the devices, but especially at this price point. And what we are delivering on all of these is the latest Android experience, right? This one, the Nokia 3, starts with, like you mentioned earlier, it starts with the 7.0, but it will be updated as and when the chipset has support for it. So we will deliver software updates to the later versions of Android, and we will also do monthly security updates. So think about it, at 138 euros, you're giving premium design, you have a pure Android experience, you have the latest Android, and you have security updates, and you have a great camera story, and you have the whole package in this kind of durable and trustworthy and a premium form factor. Let me tell you a couple of things. So when it comes to power users, probably the most one of the most difficult use cases from a processing power point of view is streaming. And I have been using this device myself and it beats a lot of flagship devices on the streaming experience, and you should try it out. And the reason for that is that it's not only about the processor choice that you do. It's about the processor, it's about the OS that sits on top of it, it's about the firmware layer, and then it's about how do you optimize for key experiences across. And what we focused on is key experiences. So even if you see it versus a 625, inherently, 625 is actually a little older, inherently from a battery optimizer, battery consumption point of view or power saving point of view, the 430 processor is actually better. I think 18% better is what Qualcomm has put out. So I'm just using their data. Also, like I said, what matters really is how does the experience work. And I mentioned that as our first pillar, we focus on core experiences. So be it battery life. So I've been using the Nokia 6, the China version for a while, and it lasts me through the day. And the previous Android phone that I used, I would run out of charge at about 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock. That's just one example. But, you know, if you look at streaming, if you look at gaming, high graphics gaming, the GPU that you have on the 430 is an Adreno 505 versus I think it is a 405 on the, at least the 617. So I'll have to check that. But basically what it means is it's great on graphics performance, it's great on battery, and that's what led us to the choice of the chipset. And I think it delivers a really, really good experience at this price point. So the chipset obviously supports quick charge. So if you're talking about the Snapdragon ones, but our inbuilt, so the fast charging, as we call it these days, is about the plug that you have, the cable that you use, and obviously the support in the chipset. So the chipset supports quick charge. By default, what we have on, and I'll have to check the actual spec, but we have the 5 volt 2 amp. Yes, all of them support 4G Volte out of the box, and they will work on Reliance Jio. So what I can tell you is that we have, with this range, we've really innovated in the sense that we have democratized premium. If you see what we've done here, we've really made premium accessible to all. It's not that you need to have a very high price phone to get premium. We've said that even at a 139 euros, you will do premium. What the other thing I can tell you is that we will always focus on what's really important for consumers and what we think is relevant for consumers. And that's what we are basing our strategy on. So you can stay tuned for more.